Alright guys, welcome to another video. This morning I'm going to be taking Mike's car to the paint shop. We're going to get the engine bay painted and the cage. We're still waiting on a hood, or else we'd paint the whole thing. But we're going to start with the engine bay and the cage. That way we're not just sitting around waiting. And we're going to actually be making progress so we can put the motor back in and all of the interior. Mike's already made good progress dyeing all of his interior pieces black. I guess these cars never came with black interior. That kind of sucks. And he has like the worst color, that poopy brown, like 90s poopy brown interior. So got to back the trailer into the shop and then try and load this thing up. And then I'll be on my way to Brian's. All right, so now Mike's car is at the paint shop and won't see that for another 2 weeks probably. So while that's out of here, I'm going to focus on some of the other things that are on the list, like repairing this bash bar so we can send these out to get powder coated. Mike had a little bit of an off-road excursion and the jack point stuck into the ground and got like ripped off, so gonna go ahead and sleeve it with this material that actually fits inside there. So I'm gonna shove it in there as far as I can and then throw a nice weld around it. And then from hitting the wall, I believe it was on this side, you can see it's got a nice little scrape there from dragging on a wall. It kind of started to crack a weld on the back here. So weld that up, do that, fix that, and then those will be ready to go to powder coat. And then the other thing I am doing is modifying the valve covers. So this is the factory PCV. We're going to block that off. We're going to block off the crossovers and the original breather. So all of that's going to get deleted. And then I'm going to weld on these two dash sixes on here. And we're going to end up building a nice catch can for this thing. And then these are actually going to get polished. I'm going to take them to Mile High Polish and get those things looking awesome. So then that way we don't have to paint them again. I think it'll just be a cleaner look too with all of the pulleys he's got and all the other shiny bits like his intercooler piping. And then the last thing that I think I'm going to try and take care of either today or tomorrow is building a fan shroud. I went and picked up some aluminum for that. It's this sheet of 16th of an inch aluminum that'll end up getting used up and we'll do something cool. And hopefully there's a little bit left over so then I can do like an upper air guide, because right now he didn't have an air guide, so I have a feeling that the air was kind of just like entering the front of the car and then going up and over the radiator because it just had like this big opening there. So I'm gonna go ahead and close that off so it's getting more direct airflow to the radiator and the intercooler and all that. And then the other thing I could probably take care of is these coilovers got welded on crooked. I didn't do that, but probably going to have to cut them and reposition them and throw a better looking weld on them as well. So yeah, got quite a bit of stuff still to do, even with the car not here. So I'm going to go grab a quick bite to eat and I'm going to come back and start on these valve covers. Got the valve covers all welded up. I didn't particularly like the way it was welding, so I went ahead and just like blended it all together. It's all nice and smoothed out. There was an opening there. It's filled in. Big opening there that got filled in. And then the two for the crossovers that got filled in. So that's pretty much what it's gonna look like. And the lines are gonna come across and go this way. The catch can's gonna be somewhere over here. These are gonna get polished. This is gonna get repolished. This is gonna get painted a different color. I think it's all gonna look really good. Also went ahead and welded up the bash bar that Mike broke. Check that out. Nothing too crazy. Basically just shoved that in there and welded it. Kind of welded like poopy because of sandblast and it got like all impregnated. So it was like spitting and popping, doing all sorts of weird shit. Pretty late now. Don't think I'm going to have a chance to mess with the fan shroud tonight, but I'll get the radiator out and the fans and get that ready to work on for tomorrow. But yeah, I'm going to go home now and do more on Mike's car tomorrow when I get here and keep checking stuff off the board. God damn it, Colorado! God damn it! I hate snow. I hate being cold. It is like my biggest aggravation ever is being cold. I miss California, but still gotta get work done, so just whipped up this quick fan shroud for Mike's car. For his twin 10-inch fans. I think those are 10s. Anywho. But yeah, it's all welded up the side covers, and it fits really well. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clean it up, DA it, make it look all nice and pretty, put like a seal around the edge of it, throw everything together on this, and then that'll be done. Then move on to fixing his coilovers. Mike's actually gonna be here today. He's gonna take his intake manifold off, and when we send the valve covers to get polished, we're gonna have the intake manifold on this thing polished too. It's just gonna make it look so much better in that engine bay, because right now that that intake manifold kind of looks crusty and shitty, so it'll be nice to make that look good when you pop the hood on that thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish this up and move on to the next thing. All right, so got Mike's fan shroud all done, threw the edge guard on it, and got all the new hardware in it, socket head cap screws, threw one on the side here so it's nice and sealed, and then threw a little bit of edge guard between the mount there so it doesn't kind of just like rattle and break or like work a hole through it or something. So now I checked that off the board. Mike's over here dyeing carpet and taking his intake manifold off. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut these fuckers apart and re-weld those and see if I can make them good.
Giggity giggity.
All right, so I repaired Mike's coilovers, cut them off, and then slid the bodies all the way down to the knuckle and made sure they were the same left to right and welded those on. And then Marco came and dropped his car off. I don't want to talk bad about anyone, but he had another shop local to me put a cage in this thing, and they didn't pre-fit anything, so when they put the dash bar in, now the gauge cluster doesn't fit, so he needs me to build him a custom gauge cluster. And I already have all the gauges and the Dakota Digital tack converter. While it's here, I'll probably do a corner balance alignment on it, because that was one thing he was interested in doing. But this car is pretty cool. I like the body kit. Well, when this thing had the full kit on it, it looked really nice. Sylvia front, big Wedds cranes on it. Pretty cool looking car. And he's probably actually going to go to Brian, the same guy that's painting Mike's Cressida right now, to have this thing refreshed and repainted. But yeah, now what I'm working on before I can get to this car is I got to pull the body and stuff off the 55 Chevy and get started on doing the frame conversion on that. So, because the oil pan... Alright, so I got the body off this thing. Got the cherry picker here just kind of supporting it. I think what I'm going to do is I'm also going to ratchet strap it to the lift just so the back end doesn't fall down when I cut this thing. This is the new front frame clip for it. And then before I did anything, I got it all level and I did a bunch of measurements, basically trim measurements, length measurements, and height measurements. So then that way I can be sure when I weld the new one on, it'll go on and actually fit. All the body mounts will line up and everything should be good. I actually just like checking this front end that got welded on. This is a Camaro front end. I don't know the year, but you can see they cut it and welded this one on, and this one's actually off by about 3/16 of an inch out of square, and it's actually not level. It's actually not level either. This side's about a degree and a half higher than the rest of the chassis, because the whole back of the chassis is level and square and everything, but yeah, this front end's just a little a little out of spec. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start cutting off those old transmission crossmember mounts, because that's pretty much directly where I'm cutting this frame and where the new one's going to slip on over it. So those got to go away. And then once he puts the LS in this thing, he'll probably bring it back to me to build a custom trans crossmember for it. But I'm going to go ahead and start cutting on this thing. All right, well, I got everything supported as well as I think I possibly can. Got the two pipe stands under the front, cherry picker grabbing the cross member, and a strap under the back of the frame. I cut the old trans cross member out, and I already marked it where I'm going to cut it, and I already cut the bottom of the frame so I don't have to be crawling underneath there. So now I'm going to start cutting the sides, and then I'll cut the top, and then bloop, that thing will go away. So it's going to be heavier than shit since it has like all the control arms and brakes and steering box and all that shit. I'm just hoping, I hope it doesn't fall. I really hope it doesn't fall. That would suck. All right, well, after lots of straining and aggravation, got the front clip off on the floor, got this one hanging from the cherry picker, got the frame rails prepped and ground down, and threw some weld through primer on them, and I threw just a little tick mark right where basically it needs to go. So only thing that I have to do now is I measured the distance between those, and I'm sure that's like a controlled distance or they wouldn't have welded, you know, those braces in between it to keep it that way. But these frame rails are too narrow to fit inside of those by about a half an inch, so I'm probably gonna have to bust out the porta power, spread that open a little bit, and then get this up there and try and fit it on. Alright, so I got the front clip on. I had to put pressure back on it to get it to line up right. I was kind of struggling because I couldn't get it to line up off my measurements from the body mounts. But it was square to like all the suspension pickup points to the rest of the chassis, and I realized that these things are actually pretty flimsy and they move around a lot, and I'm pretty sure they just got tweaked in shipping. But as far as the frame being square to all the suspension pickup points to the rest of the frame, good to go. I tweaked these a little bit and I have everything level again. Have a level on top of the shock towers here, or the control arm towers. Had to put a little bit of weight down on this thing. I have a ratchet strap pulling down on the frame rail there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to weld the bottom of that side first, so when it pulls, it'll hopefully alleviate that. And then I think I'm pretty much ready to weld this thing. It's all good to go. Make sure this is still zero. Perfect. So, yeah, I think I'll cut that brace off. Eh, maybe not. No, I'll cut that brace off and then I'll go to town welding this thing. All right, well, I got everything welded, and I welded on these big-ass fish plates on the outside of the frame just to, you know, give it more strength there at the weld mitt. And then I went ahead and painted the top side of everything up to about here, so then that way when they want to paint the frame, they don't have to pull the body off again. They can just paint everything that's going to be visible, since all the top side of it's taken care of. I primed it and then just put, like, some high temp engine enamel, so I'm gonna let that dry and then put the body mounts on, and then drop the body on it, and should be calling it for the night after that. All right, so I'm pretty sure the paint's all dry. I threw all the body mounts and stuff on. I also threw the rear wheels on because this thing tucks so much tire that you can't get the wheels off with without dropping the shocks. So just do it now, that way I don't have to drop the shocks to put the wheels on, so on and so forth. But yeah, I'm gonna lower this thing down and hopefully the body mounts line up. Hopefully they're not too fucking tweaked, but we'll see. Here pretty late last night, but I got the body all situated on the chassis, painted all the top side, all the body mounts are in. So couple things, it wasn't just like super easy to put back on. I think this front clip had some fabrication issues. Like, I think these body mounts are welded on too high, because when the body's just resting there, this is sitting pretty hard, and then this had like a half inch gap on this one, so the bumper wouldn't line up. So I ended up having to put a longer bolt in that and kind of squeeze it down, and then it just compressed that body mount, so I might have to cut that one off or something. But other than that, just waiting for the suspension to come bolted on so it could roll out of here. And then my boy Marco dropped off his car, his S13 coupe, started building his gauge cluster. Grab my flashlight. So you can see I got the basically the shape of it all there, the back panel and the two screws up in the factory mounts, and then kind of his lower piece was broken, but I kind of just like trimmed it and threw it in there just to see if like one that wasn't broken would fit. I might just glue that one back together. And all of the chassis side of the harness for the cluster is already done, and I have it into like a six wire plug. So then basically it's just going to be one plug, and then he can pull his cluster out. It's going to be super simple. So yeah, it's been a long day. Mike came and he painted his stuff. This was like the closest fluorescent yellow he could find, I guess. I'm kind of not sold on it. I think we're going to end up probably doing a wrinkle black on all of this, and then I think that'll look pretty good. I was kind of thinking of doing it body color, but I think that'll be like too much purple paint, so kind of sucks that didn't work out. But yeah, I'm gonna head out and keep working on all this stuff tomorrow. All right, back at it today. I've been working on Marco's car, so for the most part his gauge cluster is done. Really stoked on the way it came out. Super simple, just a tack, fuel level, oil pressure, and then he's got coolant and boost over there. The lower piece that held the hazard switch and some other stuff, it was broken in half prior, so I actually have it over there. It's being glued together in half, and I'm going to put that back in his column covers, and then just tie up a couple loose wires I have under the dash on the passenger side, and then that portion of it will be done. And originally we were talking about having me do some touch on some cage work on this thing, but he's trying to make an event March 9th, and that's not like high priority right now or anything, but he does want me to relocate his steering rack instead, because he doesn't want to have to run offset rack spacers, and I don't blame him, because if you guys saw what happened to me at All Star Bash, that wasn't even an offset rack spacer and it still failed. So that's what I'm going to be working on next. I'm probably just going to like clean everything up, finish what I'm doing inside the car, and then jump directly onto doing that, because I need this car to be off the lift. And then I'll probably just like do like a quick toe adjustment in the front end to make sure it's okay, throw it on the scales, see if it needs a corner balance or not. I assume it probably does, but still waiting on the suspension to show up for this. Mike's car has not been painted yet. It's at the paint shop, but still hasn't been painted. And then Glenn is bringing me back the Raptor that I built the exhaust for. It needs some stiffer hangers on the very end of the exhaust where it pokes through the bumper, because when it gets hot it moves and it kind of just like barely touches the bumper. So I'm going to put some more rigid hangers in it, like what I did on the Pontiac. These nice weld-on Stainless Works ones that have the polyurethane isolator. So, yep, I'm going to keep thrashing away on this, and when I get into doing the steering rack, I'll start recording again.
Ooh, Jesus. Focus. There we go. So I got all the trim basically around the cluster in. I had to repair that lower piece, like I said. Got the column covers in and got it basically looking the way it should. So now that that's all done, I'm going to move on to doing the subframe. Pretty stoked on that, though. All right, well, I got Marco's car up in the air, got the wheels off, lower control arms and tension rods unbolted, tie rods are off, steering column is disconnected, power steering lines, and the skid plate is off. So, and I unbolted the motor mounts, those are out. So basically right now there's just two nuts supporting it. We're gonna hold the motor up with the cherry picker and then pull the subframe out. Mike was kind enough to just pull out the cherry picker for me. So, yeah, everything underneath here is like super filthy. If you watch my videos, Marco, you need to get under your car more often because your tie rods are all loose and shit too. Like, this side, you can't really see. Yeah, here, take that. So that's the inner tie rod there. That's not supposed to move.
That'll buff right out.
Yeah. Two full turns it got loose. So I'll go ahead and take care of that for you since I'm such a nice guy, and I'll even grind your knuckles so you can actually get a nut on your tie rod there.
And I cleaned up SR20 for you. Yeah, just polish that up real nice.
Yeah, church it up.
Church it up.
Yep. Oh, and I hammered your tension rod bracket straight.
We love you so much.
Yeah, just because you take care of me with my tires, dude. All right, so subframe has been cut. I took it over to the car wash and power washed it because this thing was caked in like a quarter inch layer of muck. So I took 3/4 inch out of it and prepped it all, and now I just got to weld it. And then I'm going to have to make little plates that go in there and then radius that or cut that back so that doesn't look out of place. And then I prepped it in a way to where those two holes, I'm going to be able to rosette weld those, and then I'll just weld the whole front edge, and then I'll have to knock two holes through the lower panel so the skid plate can still mount up. But moving right along, I want to get this thing welded and at least painted tonight, and then I'll throw it in the morning and then align this thing, corner balance it, and then Marco's car will be done. All right, well, Marco's subframe is all done. Just threw a coat of paint on it. I should have taken a video before I painted it so you guys could have seen the welds, but it's all welded up. I drilled the holes for the skid plate to mount, and it all looks pretty good. So let this dry, come in the morning and install that. It's like 10 o'clock at night now. Been a long ass day, so yeah, come and finish this thing off tomorrow, hopefully. So got Marco's subframe back in for the most part. I wanted to show you guys this. One thing you got to do when you relocate the steering rack is you got to cut the excess of the lower control arm bolt off because it'll catch on the inner tie rod and actually ruin your steering rack. So that's pretty much one of the last things I got to do is cut that off and then just go ahead and tighten everything up, throw some power steering fluid in it, and check the toe. And that should be done. So yeah, just gonna button up the last little bit of it and put it back down on the ground. Marco's car is all done. Got the alignment and the corner balance done on it. Corner balance turned out pretty good. It was way off when I originally threw it on the scales. It had like a 60% cross weight. Got that down to like 51%. Front to back, I think is like 53-47 in the back. So. I mean, I could raise the front of the car up a little bit more or drop the rear, but I don't want the car to look funny and have like a reverse rake. So it's pretty close for what it is. The alignment was way off. So, I mean, it's going to drive a lot better now. So I'm stoked for him to come pick this up and drive it and, you know, give me his feedback on it. Glenn came and picked up the front clip for that thing. They got the wrong front suspension parts. It's C6 Corvette that they needed. They ended up getting a C5 Corvette stuff brought to their shop. So this thing's kind of on hold. Mike's been kind of plugging away at his thing. I mean, really, we're just waiting for the car to come back. So it's pretty late now, but I have a lot of stuff that I need to catch up on. I need to produce two steering knuckle kits, so I'm going to at least get those started tonight, get them cut and beveled, and maybe tack together and then weld them and paint them tomorrow. The brake lines for those kits are in, so should be able to ship those before the end of the week. That's the plan. And I need to do my prototype aluminum ones as well. And then tomorrow I need to work on Kevin's car. And I went and bought material, but I left it in the back of Mike's truck. So I don't know what I'm going to do about that. But yeah, I'm going to bang up these knuckles right now, or at least get started on them.